пациент, есть люди. Он этот. Там это, веревка лишняя.
Жень.
Да.
Что-то я даже не надо поперек.
Okay, so can you tell us the name of your group, where you're from, and what you were in the forests here in Mjasnoj Bor for?
Okay, yeah. So our group is called Sniezhni Desant of Kazan University and Gymnasium number 122 from Kazan. And the goal of the expedition is to find and to identify the remains of soldiers which died here in 1942 during World War II. And what we are doing is just searching the remains here in forest in different directions to collect the remains, to pass it to the headquarters, and in a few days there will be funerals of the soldiers, the in memorial, and also very important, maybe the main goal is informing relatives, families about the fathers, grandfathers, about the circumstances of their death.
Okay, and to be able to inform the families, you have to identify the bodies. How many? What percentage can you usually identify, and by what method?
It's difficult to evaluate. I think about 10% of the soldiers we can to identify, using, for example, the names on spoons, the so-called medallions with paper with the name of the soldiers. But 70 years, so paper, these papers are in a very bad condition, and not every soldier here had this medallion. So the chances are not high, but it's possible still.
Can you explain to us what you're doing and how it works exactly, this tool you're using?
I'm trying to find bones using the shoop. So when I dig the shoop into the ground, it makes the special sound. So, and it actually feels differently every time I dig it. So when it is wood, the shoop actually makes the sound, I would say, very, not loud, but with a vibration.
So you can manage to see a difference, for example, between a stone, a tree root, metal, yeah. All that, yeah, when you're used to it? Okay.
When it is metal, it usually sounds like a sand, you know, like.
Okay.
And when it is a stone, it sounds like glass, you know. Like, and when it is the bone, you know, your heart actually tricks. You know, you can feel when it is a bone.
Okay, okay.
You can't explain the sounds of the bone.
And can you show us quickly what you found in this hole?
So there is a gas mask. So the long one, it was like very deep.
Okay.
And then, you know, like parts of the mask with the glass.
And what else did you find here?
I guess ergode. But that was found by another digger.
This is a grenade, eh?
Yeah.
Okay. What is this, Ruslan?
This is... от дегтярева For a machine gun?
Yeah, machine gun, bit it off.
Russian, German?
Russian. He stay in up and fire from this.
And it's still full with the bullets, yeah? Okay, so tell me about what you found.
So just at the foot of this tree we found this Russian mug with some bullet or shrapnel damage. Obviously some other diggers found it maybe last year or 2 years ago and it wasn't interesting for them. But for me it's interesting because of the battle damage you can see on it, so I'm going to try to keep it.
And under it?
It has some writing, I'm not sure what it says, we'll have to clean it up afterwards. It's still in good condition, you see.
Yes, you have the jaw here.
So what did you just find?
This grenade was just near the leg, in that place. Yes, so probably it was on that kind of pocket.
On the soldier?
On the soldier, yeah.
Okay, can you show it to me from close?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Washing my hands in the muddy water.
Why are you eating a Toblerone in the forest? You always eat this every time?
No, we are lucky this time because our friends from France brought us this.
When
you're present.
When you want something sweet.
It gives us energy.
Toblerone!
When you feel bored, when you feel blue, eat Toblerone!
You're making shampoo?
Лисан, ты голову моешь, да?
What you are holding in your hands?
It's a spoon.
Okay.
Found in the forest where we walk, and there are some letters.
Okay.
Letters on this part of the spoon. So there is some chances that we'll be able to read. Maybe it's family name of the soldier. So just we will clean this part.
But after cleaning the spoon, you found the name Buharov written on it.
Yeah.
What did you manage to find out with this name?
Yeah. After we clean the spoon,
yes,
and read this family name, Bukharov, the name of the soldier, we send this information to our headquarter in our coordinator in Kazan,
yes,
Rafik Salahiev, and he in 2 hours he called us and said that 3 soldiers with the family name Bukharov were here, but one is probably it's here. One Bukharov, Filip Dmitrievich, he died 3 kilometers to the northwest of Mjasnoj Bor, so exactly this place. And we know that the military unit where he was, it's Strelkovaya Divizia number 374. It was this division was here,
okay,
in this forest. So I think the probability is about 80% that this spoon belong to this soldier.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
What are you going to eat, Vincent?
First sausage, you can see them over the fire and drying. And,
yes, yes.
Then after that, it's,
what's this one?
It's big fat, just fat.
Okay, it's good?
Yes, of course. It's really good. When you're in the forest, everything is good.
So what's the garlic for?
Just for health, let's say.
For what? Health?
For health, yeah.
Okay, and for good breath?
Yeah.
to avoid that. Illness and kisses.
Yeah. To avoid both of them.
I'm a superstar.
Yeah, yes you are.
Надо поплю вообще.
Все, Андрей пропит. В унисон с тобой вообще.
Ты пропишь вообще?
А? Ты пропишь. Я вообще
его. So can you tell me what you found on this wall this morning?
This morning I will find some pieces, little pieces of bones. I found what that?
It's wax or something?
Yes, wax. Something found two German buttons.
Okay.
It's. I think we will find again. So it's, this is too many pieces of bones.
And why do you find so many pieces of bone just on the side of the these big craters like this?
Because some people come here before, and when this hole was dry.
Yes.
They put all this ground under this hole.
Yes.
And take it here.
So they were digging before?
Yes, it was digging before.
Okay.
20 years ago, I think.
Okay.
We can show you one bomb here near. We can show you machine gun, German.
Okay.
We can show you many German things. Many, a lot of anything here you can find.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
And you like to dig also?
Last year I found this machine gun, a German machine gun, in this place.
Okay, so this was German positions and Russian positions.
This is positions was like Germans this and Russians.
Always fighting.
Changed. Yes.
Okay.
Because there was very big fighting. Yes. Big
okay. Fighting. Can you show me from close? Do you think it's MG 34? I think. Eh?
Yes, I think this is MG. Okay. But I don't know 34 on the or 42.
Vive la France!
Вполне нужно людям, сюда себе поедем.
Хочешь убежать, но впереди они опять мелькают между елок. Откопай меня скорей, умоляю снова. Я Машанников Сергей, родом из Подскова. Адресок мой передай в родную сторонку. 18-й квадрат, черная воронка.
What's your name and how old are you?
Hi, my name is Aynur. I'm 19.
Okay. It's the first time you come to the forest?
Yes, it's first time.
And you were never digging before?
Never.
Can you tell us what happened yesterday when you tried to use the probe, the shoop, for the first time?
Yes, everybody go to the to find some bodies. I come for this trip, and when everybody come to cut the grass, I start do similar things and find a piece of head of one of the
soldiers.
Yes, I only cut the grass and look under the this thing and find the small piece of bone.
Okay, and you found it the first time you used the shoop, you immediately found the bone. It's very lucky.
I used it first time.
And just a few meters away from the camp.
Yes, it's near the camp. It's really strange and interesting.
So in this bag, this is where some of the bones are from the soldier?
Yes, I can show you. It's pieces of head and ribs.
And ribs, okay.
Yes.
And here there's still the arm, I see.
It's a hand, I think. It's not so long. It's smaller than legs.
Yes.
And a second hand was found near this wood.
Okay. And was there anything with the body? Some objects? Some.
Yes, I find some gun. No guns.
Bullets.
Bullets. Yes. And something brush to
to clean the rifle.
To clean the rifle. Yes.
It's here, I think. Yeah?
Yes.
So this is to clean the rifle.
Yes.
Okay.
This piece, this go here, and it can be long.
Okay. And here I see the bullets also, huh? The tree here. So Russian bullets also. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
So here, as you can see, we're pretty much in a mass grave site. There's helmets, shoes, all over the place. And in the previous years, the group found a lot of Russian bodies here. There's things hanging from the trees, gas masks, mugs, all kinds of things. But we came here to metal detect the area because when they exhumed the bodies, I don't think they used metal detectors, or if they did, they might have left things over. So we tried metal detecting here, and particularly under the tree. And under the tree we found this, what is apparently the handle of a knife, a homemade knife. And it has a name carved into it, which is very difficult to see, but it's there. So it won't enable us to actually identify a specific body, but it will enable us to say that the soldier whose name is written on this knife handle was probably killed in this area. And if it's possible to locate his family or whatever, then it'll be sent back to the family. So it's a really nice find for us.
пойдемте. Вопрос только в том, надо опять в лес, видимо, возвращаться сейчас, тут, потому что сложно.
Прием. Вы где находитесь? Ну, где-то рядом с памятником, тут это, бурелом.
Одно дерево, второе.
Plus aussi, pour vérifier. Okay. Là, c'est ça le mot.
Attends.
Mais ce sont les clés d'obus, ou tout comme ça, tu vois. Pas top, tu vois.
Ah, je
l'ai. C'est une vanne de main allemande.
Ok.
So here, it was something was ringing like really loud and deep. So we suspected it's probably a shell. And after cleaning it out, you can see that it's a shell with. Here, there's the copper driving band. Wait, you can't see it because of the water now. Well, anyway, it's an unexploded shell, so we leave it where it is. Пошли.
Вази.
Looks like a shell casing. So, what did you find here?
We found two jawbones, one bottle and one hand grenade. There's also a vertebra here. So we think it's garbage from previous black diggers which came here and were digging around. So I'm gonna take the jawbones now. First one. Bottle is in good shape. And there's nothing written on the bottom. So we can say, and the hand grenade is stuck under a root.
Okay, maybe we should leave it for now.
Mm-hmm.
So it says Death Valley, terrible hell. Those who survived this hell won't forget it. It was very hard to die here, especially if you're not even 20. And this is Russian tradition to honor the dead comrades. This is a glass of vodka, bread and cigarette.